Bring it in. Keep coming. Oh, time for an upgrade. Radar Presto.
Say, these are nice.
Stunning.
On you go.
Good afternoon, I'm Captain Lou Albabo here with AK 40 Ounce, and you are watching the 2014 Division II playoffs from Kitchener, Waterloo, Ontario, Canada, brought to you by Tri-City Roller Derby and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association.
We got a great matchup coming up here, the penultimate game. This is for the bronze, Captain Lou. We have the number four seed, Kalamazoo Derby Darlings, pardon me, Michigan teams, love to see it. We've got Kalamazoo, number four, coming in against number seven. Big upset. Could not quite get to the finals, but a great showing from Gold Coast. It's going to be an awesome game, Captain Lou.
I'm looking forward to it. On the team in black, that's the Kalamazoo Derby Darlings. They are sending 11:48 Alley K Contusions. 11:50 is Neva. 13, Lily St. Smear. 13:13 Dubois. 17:76 Merica. 2:17 Emma Pistol. 3:14 Heckler. 33 Javelin. 3:65 Misbehavin. 480 Crash of Aggressive, 5 Roller Rammer, 77 Heartless Haughty, 78 Beaver Jam, 89 Jesse Girl, the Alts are Nancy Drew Blood and Tarantula.
And for the ladies in red from the Gold Coast, Derby Girls All-Star Zero, Suki Skankow, she is the captain, 000 Bitchin' and Rollin', number 13, 37 Bandita, 143 Baller Shot Caller, number 28 Cleopatra Heartbreaker, 30, 24 Freakerella, 422 Annihilating Eddie, number 47 Soldierner, 49er Papa Panther, 51 Lil Scrap, 5x5 Bell Kabong, 82 Rageaholic Rex, 88 Lucy Lunatic, number 9 Kitten Not Submittin', Barely Human on the bench with one of these skaters. It's number 117.
117.
A reverse cowgirl. Those are the teams.
We'll get to the officials later on because we've got the 3-4 matchup about to get underway. On the fast girl skate, jammer line is Dubois in black for Kalamazoo. Quickly through, she's going to get a lead jammer. First lead jammer of the game. Double, triple zero is Bitchin' and Rollin' for Gold Coast. She is stuck at the back of the pack. Now accelerating through the pack, getting lead, or not lead jammer, but out. Dubois coming around, coming up on the back of the pack, looking to pick off points before Bitchin' and Rollin' can get through. Gets knocked to the outside, has to call it off. 3 points for Kalamazoo, AK.
Yep, first penalty of this game. Suki Skankhouse taking a seat in the notorious RED penalty box. A beautiful apex jump right at the end from the Gold Coast jammer, but it was far after the whistles, so no points for them. Looking back at Dubois, expect to see a lot from her. She has been their leading scorer coming into this game. 110 points, shortly followed thereafter by Heckler and Jessie Girl with 102 and 100 respectively.
On the fast girl skate, Jammerline, Heckler and 49er. That is Pow Pow Panther.
Seen some good things from Pow Panther, blocking and jamming. She has 29 points. She got those all in the first game.
Baller Shot Caller with a nice hit to the inside, resets Heckler to the back. At the front, Pow Pow Panther working against a four wall of black uniformed skaters from Kalamazoo holding her at a standstill. She is unable to get any forward motion. A little bit of offense from Gold Coast trying to spring open that wall, but the heckler coming from all the way behind through the front of the pack. Lead jammer, two jams in a row.
Yeah, great job by heckler to keep it pushing. Drew a penalty, so there was only two defenders out there for Gold Coast. Now back up to three as heckler flies by in a five-point pass.
And still stuck in the pack is Pow Pow Panther, still trying to work her way through the Kalamazoo pack. Kalamazoo blockers, nice discipline early on in this game, doing a good job. Pow Pow Panther finally getting out of the pack. She'll be able to stem the bleeding now. Heckler knocked to the outside by Baller Shot Caller. She's going to reset, trying to pick off that final point, decides to go to the hips, calls off the jam. She had all four of them anyways, AK.
Yeah, fantastic job right there. Pow Pow Panther had some trouble. Watch out, because Gold Coast has a deep jammer rotation. We've seen Bitchin' and Rollin', Suki Skankhouse, Pow Pow Panther, Baller Shot Caller, Kitten Not Submitting, Soul Journer, and Lucy Lunatic all jam in this tournament. So they have options depending on the style of play they're opposed with.
Yeah, they've got some serious skating skills on this Gold Coast team.
And if you want to show off your skating skills, you might want to check out Rydell Skates. Rydell Skates, unmatched quality, unmatched performance. RydellSkates.com.
Again, Gold Coast in red, Kalamazoo in black. It is Allie Kate Contusions taking the star this time for Kalamazoo. Lead jammer once again for the Michiganders. She gets knocked out of bounds, but it was out of play. She's able to reset. Had lead jammer.
Way out front was that hit from Bitchin' and Rollin'. She will be joined in the notorious REBD penalty box by Lucy Lunatic. Early penalty trouble here for Gold Coast.
And through the front of the pack, rotates, goes inverted, calls it off with the hands on the hips, and 4 points, 3 points, 3 points for Allie K. Contusions, 12, 15 nothing now for Kalamazoo.
Yep, not a lot of numbers on the scoreboard for Gold Coast, but already in trouble in the penalty board, relatively speaking. It's early on. They have four penalties. That's not massive trouble, but Lucy Lunatic, who's been good on both sides, with two. Kalamazoo's problem coming into this was penalties. Looking so far so good on cleaning it up.
Jessie Girl taking the star for Kalamazoo. That's number 47, Souljourner for Gold Coast. Souljourner coming up against the back of the pack, gets knocked to the outside. She has to reset, and that is going to allow Jessie Girl to get through the front of the pack. Lead jammer once again, Kalamazoo trying to put down the hammer early in this game, trying to pull a nice lead, and there's 5 points for Jessie Girl, and she's off to the races. She has an opportunity to get another scoring pass in. A Souljourner is about 30 feet behind her. Kalamazoo keeping that pack at a standstill, then pushing forward. Heartless Hottie breaking up that wall. Jam called off. Another nine. It's a 9-point jam for Jessie Girl.
4 points being awarded right at the end there. Also a penalty being assessed at the end of the jam. We'll see that one coming in. Meanwhile, I'd like to thank Print Co. Graphics. PrintCoGraphics.com for all your printing needs. Hit up PrintCoGraphics.com.
So we have a team timeout with 4 minutes and 1 second gone in this game for Gold Coast. Yeah, they're down 24 to nothing in the first four jams of this game. Barely Human, I guess, deciding that he wanted to pull the reset and, you know, just get his team reorganized. They have played very well this weekend, but Kalamazoo looking for the bronze. They won the bronze last year when they hosted the Division II tournament in Kalamazoo. Looking to repeat that performance, AK.
Yeah, came in at third last year, stayed at third, came in one down this year as the four seed, but have done well with themselves. They were defeated in a heartbreaker for them by Bear City, and it was 232 to 185, and as I mentioned, penalties were a big part of that one. Nevasoba and Javelin both fouled out, and a lot of jammer penalties in the first half.
Fast Girl Skates, jammer line, start line, seeing Kitten Not Submitting for Gold Coast, and it is Dubois jamming for Kalamazoo, and she's got a lead. She gets knocked to the inside. She's going to have to reset. And a track cut to Kitten Not Submitting. That's going to let Dubois have a power jam. She's already got lead. She is now out of the pack, completing that initial pass. She has an opportunity to score here. All four red blockers, Gold Coast, on the track. So we'll see how the defense holds up. And now springing forward, providing a little bit of offense as Kalamazoo spreading that wall out, creating some chaos.
Big takedown by Freakarella. And as she goes down, there's going to be a low block penalty assessed. to Dubois, so it'll be a power jam now as the jammer Kitten Not Submitting returns for Gold Coast.
Right, we'll go the full 2 minutes. Now Kitten Not Submitting is still on her initial pass, but she's going to get out relatively quickly as the front wall of Gold Coast blockers picked off the defenders from Kalamazoo, allowing those gaps. Penalty is over. Dubois back on the track. Now both jammers are eligible to score. And blocking out of bounds on Dubois, her second penalty in this jam. It's back onto the power jam for Kitten Not Submitting, and she has the first 5 points for Gold Coast.
Going to Notorious RD penalty box, Lily St. Smear taking a seat for a high block, as well as Dubois as a quick scoring pass right there again for Kitten Not Submitting, Captain Lou.
Jam continuing on, 26 seconds remaining for Kitten Not Submitting to put points on the board. Kitten Not Submitting coming into that pack. Knocked down by big hits in that pack by
that's Neva.
It is Neva, it is. Yeah, with a stripe on her head. Javelin providing the assistance. Both of these blockers fouling out of the game yesterday, and you're seeing how important they are to the Kalamazoo defense, doing a great job of holding up Kitten Not Submitting. She did score another five, but they held her up for pretty much the remainder of that jam, limiting the damage. Couple more points for Kalamazoo, 28 to 15, AK.
Yeah, Navasoba out there, basically a kitten-seeking rocket in that last jam. Several knockdowns in a row. Kitten got some distance coming up, and Neva just with a fire in her belly. This is a bit of a redemption game for Kalamazoo. After all those penalties, they want to prove that they deserve that medal. She came up, you could see it in her eyes. She just had the red and nailed Kitten Not Submitting to the ground, but points were scored, and it's 28 to 15, Captain Lou.
4-on-3 pack advantage. Ali K. Contusion taking the star once again for Kalamazoo. Knocked to the outside, has to reset. Still stuck in the back is Bitchin' and Rollin'. Multiplayer block is Gerson number 77. Heartless Hottie to the Taurus RD penalty box. Out of the pack is Ali K. Contusion's lead jammer and a
way out of
cut.
The pack right yeah. here. Yeah, it's going to be a power jam. It's Bitchin' and Rollin' taking a seat for a track cut. It's a power jam, and that's a five-pointer for Allie Kate.
Bitchin' and Rollin' living up to her name as she got that track cut. Not happy with the call. Little bit of motion in the pack by Kalamazoo. A back block, I believe, pulled on number 3024, Freakarella. Three blockers remain on their one to beat. And then cycling back up is Pow Pow Panther. It's Sookie Skankhouse. Last line of defense. Can't keep her in there. The hands go to the hips. Five more points for Kalamazoo. They keep on rolling.
That they do. And a nice effort from Sookie Skankhouse. Got a good hit on her. And then went for the foot race. But Allie Kate with that long gate sprinting out and finishing the pass. Our score right now, 38 to 15. We have played 7 minutes and 45 seconds here. This is the 3-4 game from Kitchener-Waterloo, Ontario, WFTDA D2 International Playoffs.
Fast Girl Skate start line only has Heckler on it. That's number 314 in black for Kalamazoo. She's up against three blockers from Gold Coast who have her pinned to the inside line. She resets. She's got one to beat at the front. She's going to get free for lead jammer. Power jam is over. Bitchin' and Rollin' back on the track. All four Kalamazoo blockers setting up, and only Sookie Skankhouse is out there for Gold Coast as a blocker now, AK.
Yeah, Lucy Lunatic going to the penalty box along with Baller Shot Caller. They kept blocking out of play and both drew penalties.
Now joining Sookie is Freakarella, so they've got two back on the track now, but looks like Heckler is having a bit of trouble at the back of the pack, but now she's through. She is lead jammer. She's already picked up five. She's going to look for four this time. Bitchin' and Rollin' out of the pack. Going to be able to limit the damage. Heckler on one final scoring pass. Will she get the hands and the hips? She does. Did she call it off in time? She did. 0 to Gold Coast. 3 to Kalamazoo.
Great job. Heads up play there from Heckler. Looking back at her weekend so far, she had 67 points in the first game that went over the Chicago Outfit. What a slugfest that was, Captain.
It was.
Led all scorers in that one. Last time contributed 35, so she was the third highest scoring jammer. So 102 on the weekend, and a fine job already here today. 22 points leading Kalamazoo scoring.
That's number 89, Jessie Girl, going up against Souljourner. Jessie Girl with an inside line getting past her own wall, switches to the outside. Only two blockers on the track for Gold Coast. Penalties continuing to be a problem. Jessie Girl out for lead jammer. Souljourner also out of the pack. Jessie Girl humming around the pack quickly. None touched through on the inside. Four easy peasy points.
Yeah, one of the big things yesterday in that game against Bear City was a stat line that was of note. Jesse Girl, so clutch, picking up lead jammer. 86%, I believe, was her final. Almost every single time she was out there, she got it. Super impressive, and they're hoping she's going to continue that. It's looking consistent thus far.
Well, you know, okay, and I am a believer that everyone wishes they had Jesse Girl, so. Number 13, Dubois going up against zero. That is Sookie Skankhouse. Sookie Skankhouse up against Neva. Neva not giving an inch. Lead jammer is going to go to Dubois through once again. Sookie Skankhouse now getting out of the pack. Dubois with an opportunity to continue to increase his lead. A back four wall of red blockers set up, but Dubois with a little bump makes her own gap in that wall. Through on the inside, four more points, Kalamazoo.
Great job, and good hustle from Sookie Skankhouse. She does not get back around. Did not see any jamming at the latter part of yesterday. Did a bunch. First game, 46 points for Sookie Skankhouse. After that, did a lot more blocking, only 12 points, and did not jam in that third game against Rideau Valley.
On the fast girl skate start line is going to be Heckler once again for Kalamazoo in black. And now it's going to be number 88, Lucy Lunatic, taking the start in red for Gold Coast. Lucy Lunatic pushing up against the front, gets knocked to the outside, holds that line, gets lead jammer. It was a nice hit by Roller Rammer, but she couldn't quite get her out of bounds. Lead jammer to Gold Coast. What they need, and so that they can get points back up on the board. They've only scored once in this game so far. 15 points in that jam. Out of the pack and through on her first scoring pass now is number 88. That is Lucy Lunatic with 5 points for Gold Coast. Heckler absorbing a hit. Oh no, a forearm as she goes head to head with Bitchin and Roland, and a call off by Lucy Lunatic. 5 more points, Gold Coast.
Yeah, Lucy Lunatic right at the end there, sneaking through on the inside. Only jammed her as well. Like we talked about, they've got a lot of different approaches. Lucy Lunatic jammed in the Rideau Valley game. She had a 50% lead and put up 35 points, or 25, depending on who you ask.
Depending on which ringster stats you're looking at, or who wrote them down, or what time of day. Gonna be a...
It's exchange rate.
Hey, finally an exchange rate joke. Number 9, of course, is Kitten Not Submitting. The only jammer on the track. It is a notorious RED penalty box that is holding Heckler. And this power jam continues. Hard hits at the front of the pack, not wanting to let her out, but they have to let her go. Lead jammer to Kitten Not Submitting. Now, they did hold up 24 seconds.
Yeah, and that's that duo out there, Javelin, playing with Nevasoba. Two massive defensive threats, and they work so well together.
Well, and this is Gold Coast's fourth game, so I mean, getting knocked around by Neva and Javelin, that's going to wear out jammers much quicker than it would if they were completely fresh. 5 points to Kitten Not Submitting. Heckler out of the penalty box, through on her initial pass. Kitten Not Submitting now looking for one final opportunity to get points on the board. She gets the hands and the hips. And no additional points. Good defense on the part of Kalamazoo.
Great job by right there. Lily St. Smear forcing her out of bounds, taking a look back at earlier in the weekend. Lily St. Smear in the game against Berlin, a plus 30 as a blocker, led all their blockers. Crash of Aggressive, a plus 20 as a pivot. And, of course, they lost that game. So having that big plus line on her stats is indicative of how important she was.
No, exactly. If you're a blocker in a game that you've lost and you've got pluses in your column, you have done a fantastic job. Bitchin' and Roland taking the star for Gold Coast. Allie Kate Contusions, number 1148 for Kalamazoo. Gold Coast with that back line trying to hold Allie Kate Contusions up. Nice hit by Baller Shot Caller. Holds Allie Kate up a little bit. She's pushed to the outside, resets quickly. Still pushing up against that front wall. Bitchin' and Roland not having much luck getting past the defense of Kalamazoo. Fantastic blocking on the part of the team in black. A forearm is going to send Baller Shot Caller to the notorious RD penalty box.
Yeah, meanwhile, and that forearm pushed Allie Kate Contusions out of bounds. She came back in after the penalty, but didn't realize there was another blocker in there that she cut. So it's a power jam here for Bitchin' and Roland.
One of those penalties that are totally worth it.
Yeah, if it draws you a power jam, given it is a 4-on-2 defensive advantage here for Kalamazoo, and they're going to kill this power jam, at least that portion of it. Great job by Roller Rammer, number 5, to knock Bitchin and Roland out of bounds.
Well, Bitchin and Roland resets, looking for space. She's got it. She's going to get through. 5 fingers in there, 5 points to Gold Coast. Every jam that they've Every pass that they've had has been a five-point jam so far, a five-point pass so far.
Baller shot caller up, yep. Joining back in, so the pack advantage has gone the other way now.
There we go, a four-point pass. And she's going to call it off as Ali K contusion is about to hit the back of the pack. 39 for Gold Coast, 59 for Kalamazoo. So one little mistake by Kalamazoo and Gold Coast is roaring right back into it.
Taking a quick look at penalties, notice Afrikarella going back to the notorious RED penalty box in that one. Lucy Lunatic and Afrikarella and Bitchin' and Rollin' each with a few penalties. On the other side of things, relatively clean and very clean, comparatively speaking, looking back at KDD. They had 41 penalty minutes against Berlin. They had 41 penalties, so 20 and a half, and then 38 in their previous game against the outfit.
On the inside was Jessie Girl, but hit to the inside by Soldier, and she had to reset. And getting out first is Lucy Lunatic. She has those three trips to the notorious RD penalty box, but she is lead jammer, and a track cut. A track cut to Jessie Girl. It has turned into a power jam, only down by 20 points, Gold Coast. Nice hit to the outside. That's going to be another reset. But again, that is Neva and Javelin out there doing a fantastic job of holding up Lucy Lunatic. 5 points to Gold Coast. Now not 59 to 44. Power jam continues. Coming around another scoring pass. Javelin goes inverted with Neva. Javelin knocked to the ground.
Yeah, some force right there. That's what we saw from Lucy Lunatic yesterday. She doesn't look like it. She will blow some people up. People twice her size have gone down.
Yeah, if you're knocking Javelin off her feet, you're hitting somebody pretty hard.
Oh, yeah. Like to thank Notorious RED, Notorious Gear Deodorant by Notorious RED. Order online at NotoriousRED.com.
So, again, this is the bronze medal matchup, AK.
Yeah, and as we said, Keizu last year came in one bronze. They would love to hang the 2013 and 2014 next to each other in the trophy case. And Gold Coast here, first time in action, really making a huge statement, coming in with that first big win that was way back ages ago on Friday at noon when they defeated Grand Raggedy 213 to 197. They then went on to defeat Queen City, the big upset, and then, of course, shut down last night by Rideau Valley. Rideau Valley, of course, will be playing Bear City for the championship after this at 6 o'clock. Thank you for joining us for this one on WFTDA.TV. I'm AK. He's Captain Lou Albamo. And our score is 59-48, an 11-point game. Another close one, Captain Lou.
Oh, I love the close games. It has been a fantastic weekend of roller derby. Not every game has ended under 20 points, but really, can you expect it to be that way? And, you know, if you are excited about the roller derby action you see and you want to talk to us, please feel free to use the Twitters, hashtag #talk2WFTDA. We love to see what you have to say. Glad that you're tuning in at WFTDA.TV.
Indeed. And if you're watching this on the archive, please do not tweet. I mean, but feel free to follow at WFTDA Live and then go back and search all the hashtag WFTDA Playoffs, hashtag KWAwesome.
A power start for Bitchin' and Rolling. Kalamazoo setting up at the pivot line to give themselves a little freedom, prevent the offense from Gold Coast picking them off. Lead jammer going to Bitchin' and Rollin'. Power jam is over. Back on the track is Jessie Girl through the pack, and she has done her initial pass. Bitchin' and Rollin' looking for points for Gold Coast. Going to the outside. Gets knocked to the outside. Picked up 3 points. A single point saved by Kalamazoo.
And Gold Coast has stormed back here, an 8-point game, 59-51 in favor of Kalamazoo. But Kalamazoo has not scored in the last six jams, Captain Lou.
That is being held to a standstill. Kalamazoo's got to figure something out. Gold Coast got to be happy that they're not getting run over like they were at the beginning of this game.
Yeah, they've adjusted nicely, and what they're doing is really working Kalamazoo into the penalty box, getting those jammers to cut the track, drawing those penalties, and taking advantage then, especially when it's a 4-2 briefly power jam. They're really taking advantage, and Kalamazoo, if they're going to want to stop this momentum, they got to do is figure out that lockdown defense on the penalty kill.
Yeah, or even better, just
don't go to the box.
that's the advice every coach gives their jammers, right? Yeah, just don't get a penalty.
Great advice.
So much
easier said than done, though.
Apparently.
Kitten Not Submitting is back. on the Fast Girl Skates Jam line, and opposite her is Hackler in the black for Kalamazoo. Or, I'm sorry, that is Dubois.
And it's Sojourner as well.
Yeah, it's Sojourner. Update. F5 refresh. All right, here we go. Sojourner Dubois.
Finally, with getting a jammer at a jam start, Dubois picking up lead jammer for Kalamazoo. Sojourner working her way through the front of the pack as well. So this will likely be a single scoring pass for Dubois. She's got one to beat. That one is Baller Shot Caller. Baller unable to get her as she swoops to the outside, hits it and quits it. 4 points for Kalamazoo, 63-51 is the score.
All right, so we talked about some advice you can give to your jammer. Advice to announcers, always trust your eyes and check the actual players before you defer to the stats. All right, like to thank Rollerbones. Rollerbones and Bones Bearing make for a winning combination. You can find them online at rollerbones.com.
Penalty trouble for Gold Coast as this is a 4-2 pack start. Lucy Lunatic going up against Heckler. Heckler getting stuck on that two wall, though. Baller Shot Caller doing a great job of holding her up. That's going to let Lucy Lunatic through for lead jammer in a 4-on-2 pack advantage. You got to love it when that happens. And your jammer can bust it. And a huge apex jump lands it. Cheers from her bench in the crowds. 4 points for Gold Coast.
Yeah, the inside line. That's another piece of advice. Gotta close up that inside line. They left it open. It was weakly defended on the first pass by America, who got pushed out of the way pretty easily by Lucy Lunatic. And then the second time, it was open, went for the hit, but it was cleared already. Great job there by Lucy Lunatic to pick out the path of least resistance.
Bitching and rolling, going up against Allie K. Contusions on the Fast Girl Skate start line. Jam underway, 4-on-3 pack advantage for Kalamazoo. Kalamazoo now with the back wall. Couple blockers falling to the ground, including Javelin. Only one left at the front. That's Lily St. Smear. She cannot contain Bitchin' and Rollin'. Lead jammer going to Gold Coast. Only 8 points separating these teams, AK.
Yep. Allie Kate out. But the big thing about Bitchin' and Rollin' was she took down all those players herself individually.
Yeah, I mean, she's a tough blocker, a tougher jammer. The hands are going to the hips. 2 points. It is now a 6-point game. 63-57 in favor of Kalamazoo. 10 minutes remaining in this half.
Gold Coast, slow start, coming back into it. You got to love it. We got a 6-point game right now. And if you need to just take a break from all this action because your mind is blown, you can head on over to Adam Wheels. Adam, proud partner of the WFTDA for 6 years running, adamwheels.com. Or even better yet, open it up in a separate window.
Why not? 4-on-3 pack advantage again for Kalamazoo. They've got Sojourner pinned at the back of the pack. Jesse Girl going lateral left and right, trying to get through that front wall of red blockers. Baller Shot Caller hip into gut on Jesse Girl, having trouble getting past. Now she gets a nice move to the outside.
Wow.
Comes back inside and lead jammer for Jesse Girl.
Beautiful maneuver. Baller Shot Caller so hard to get around in the first place, but she was doing extra, it seemed, on that one. And Jesse Girl found a way right there, busted right up through the gut. And that is a grand slam for Kalamazoo.
And that pack in black is shutting down Sojourner. They've got all four of them in a diamond and closing her. Now they have to stretch out in a bridge. Sojourner pushing as hard as she can. That wall does not want to move an inch. Now she finds an inside line, but a nice last ditch effort by Heartless Hottie bumps her to the inside. She has to reset all the way to the back, and Jesse Girl is going to call. Jesse Girl calls it off. That was still on the initial pass for Sojourner, though.
Yeah, 4 quick points for Jesse Girl. And on the other side of things, Sojourner got knocked out, but she didn't look back to see that the blocker had fallen. And that's
right.
Something that you always have to, you got to keep that head on a swivel. They've done a good job with it, but sometimes you just get caught off. You get hit wrong, you're facing the wrong way, whatever the case may be.
And when you're playing for the bronze medal at a D2 tournament, that's pretty exciting.
Yeah, you must have some decent awareness.
Yeah. 5-on-5 roller derby. When we get started, we have an official timeout. Again, we have one more game, AK, after this one.
Oh.
I mean, this one's by no means over. It's 15 points separating these teams. But one more game still.
Yeah, one more game, the big one.
Right.
Todos burritos right there. The whole enchilada, as it were. The Uber game, that, I suppose, in German.
Las Uber game.
Las Uber Bout. That is going to be at midnight Germany time.
That's
so,
right.
So we thank everybody who's going to be joining us for that one. Thank everybody joining us here and all weekend. Captain Lou, it's been amazing.
Oh.
And you know what? D2's almost over. It's been a good run. I'm happy to say that both of us have been there for every second of the action.
Yep.
But We get to go home, take a quick break, and then D1 starts up again. I'll talk about that in a couple minutes. Meanwhile, we've got Bitchin' and Rollin' being knocked to the outside, the Jammer, and Dubois jamming for Kalamazoo.
Dubois knocked to the ground by Pow Pow Panther, now coming up against a two-wall, which turns into a three-wall very quickly as Pow Pow Panther resets. Dubois knocked down to the inside, but able to get up as the pack continues to roll forward. She did not have to reset. Bitchin' and Rollin' with one to beat. That one is Neva. Neva trying to hold her, cannot contain her. Bitchin' and Rollin' with lead Jammer for Gold Coast. However, Dubois is out of the pack. Bitchin' and Rollin' is going to have to be cautious with this call-off. Kalamazoo trying to get their points to the front of the pack, keeping them away from the Gold Coast Jammer. Neva gives up her point with a hit. And Bitchin' and Rollin' goes down to the ground. A single point for Gold Coast. Hard-fought single.
Yeah, that's if you're going to give up that point, that's fine as long as you force her to call it off. Great job there by Neva. Neva, one of the top playing, you know, percentage of play time right there. 11 jams for her. You've seen Heartless Hottie and Rollerama playing a lot for them. Meanwhile, Baller Shot Caller, 15 jams so far for her. Suki Skankhouse with 13, Bitchin' and Rollin', and Lucy Lunatic also with 11. So those are your big names that are playing quite a bit.
Heckler versus Lucy Lunatic on that Fast Girl Skate start line. Heckler being held at the back, and it is a blocking with the head to Lucy Lunatic. It is turned into a power jam for Heckler. Heckler has one to beat. And she's going to get past her lead Jammer. This power jam hasn't even started yet because Lucy Lunatic is just sitting down now. Now wow. 30 seconds for Kalamazoo to put points up on the board. 73 to 58, 6 minutes and 40 seconds remaining in the first half. Heckler coming through. She's got one to beat at the front. Knocked out of bounds, but the blocker also went out of bounds. She thought perhaps...
Yeah, don't
perhaps
risk it
had
right
to reset.
There.
No, it's a power jam. You might as well maximize. And you don't want to... You've seen so many... Jammer swap ups this weekend. They're going to call it off 4 points. We have so many Jammer swap ups, 5 points, yes.
Yeah, the Jammer swap, like you said, and it worked out perfectly because she got knocked out, went back to reset, took her time. They were gifted extra seconds with Lucy Lunatic taking her time to the box and were able to call it off with number 88 standing with the star in the notorious RED Sin Bin. So, power start here, Captain Lou.
And you wouldn't think that roller derby victory would go to the most cautious team, but we've seen this weekend that living on the edge is really dangerous.
Yeah, some risky maneuvers yesterday from Gold Coast, and it ended up arguably costing them the game.
Alley Kate Contusions getting lead Jammer with a power start. The power jam is over. Lucy Lunatic out of the notorious RD penalty box and now out of the pack on her initial pass. Into the pack comes Alley Kate Contusions, having to reset. Sookie Skankhouse drawing her back. She's going to have to call it off. No points to Gold Coast and a single point. One additional point for Kalamazoo. 79 to 58. 5 minutes and 20 seconds remaining in the half, AK.
Well, Captain Lou, looking at our jammer so far, Alley Kate Contusions does not like to jam.
No.
I can say that. I know her personally
as
a coach. She is very good at
it,
but she doesn't like to do it. She likes to mix it up in the pack. It has been huge for her because she is their leading lead jam percentage getter, 60% lead, tied with Dubois, 50% Heckler, 50% Jesse Girl. And we'll give you the other side after this jam.
Kitten not submitting, jamming for Gold Coast. That is number 89, Jesse Girl, being knocked out of bounds. She's going to get drawn all the way back to turn four. She has to reset. That was number 422, Annihilating Annie, doing the last bit of bridge work on that, and still stuck against that back wall of red at the front. Now Kitten not submitting, having no luck getting through the tough black wall. This pack has just crawled past turn one. 30 seconds in.
Great job by Jesse Girl to push up in between there, draw the multiplayer block, and that'll thin out the red wall. Oh, big hit up front as Jesse Girl picks up lead Jammer and a fresh bruise.
It was a huge hit. She rocked right back, shook her head, got back on her skates and kept on rolling around the track. She's taking the outside line. It's nice and safe. Good choice by Jesse Girl. That's an easy five and still stuck in that pack. Kitten not submitting. Gold Coast going to offense to try to get her out. Another big hit by Heartless Hottie. She's having a pretty fantastic game. And she's going solo against Kitten not submitting. Jesse Girl gets through for five more points and puts a hit on Kit Not Submitting. She's got called off. Thought maybe she might be able to get a baby eaten on that one.
Mm-hmm. No, at least get the extra shot in. So speaking of which, after this game, it's going to be you and I sitting in the crowd for Berlin versus Rideau, and extra shots will be ordered. So as I said, looking at the leads for the Gold Coast Derby Girls, 57% lead for Bitchin' and Rollin'. Lucy Lunatic, 3 out of 6, so 50%. And Kitten Not Submitting, no luck. Everybody else, no leads. So Kalamazoo doing a good job picking up Lead Jammer and managing the game that way.
Gold Coast going with Lucy Lunatic, but quick stepping on the outside. It's Dubois picking this team up and putting it on her shoulders, skating around the track, looking to continue Kalamazoo's lead. Nice little shoulder drop against Javelin will get Lucy Lunatic out of the pack. Dubois knocked down to the inside by Bitchin' and Rollin'. Digger, high five.
Yeah, that was a great block by Bitchin' and Rollin'. And you see, Doobie really appreciates the effort there. She's a fierce competitor, but you know what? She can appreciate other fierce competitors, and that's one of the fine things about this great sport. S1 helmets? S1 helmets are rad. Get rad.
What?
S1helmets.com.
92-58 is the score in favor of Kalamazoo. 2 minutes remaining in the period. And the jamming away Heckler. Jamming for Kalamazoo. Lucy Lunatic again. For Kalamazoo, or for
Gold Coast
for Gold
Jammer.
Coast. Yep.
Lucy Lunatic, however, of note on her stat line, she is the leading scorer for Gold Coast with 23 right here, picking up Lead Jammer, but she also has 4 trips to the penalty box, and we still have about 2 minutes left here.
High risk, high reward player out of the pack is Heckler. Lucy Lunatic coming up. She's going airborne.
Roll a rammer, just waiting right there. She hits the ground with a plastic ka-thunk.
Fool me once, shame on me. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. Yeah. Roller rammer, not getting fooled that time.
Uh-uh. That's not the inside line you're looking for. 95-58 for Kalamazoo over Gold Coast Derby Girls All-Stars here on WFTDA.TV. Captain Lou, who do we have jamming?
Fast Girl Skate Starline sees Pow Pow Panther and number 1148 Alley, Kate Contusions. Only 2 blockers out there for Gold Coast, 3 for Kalamazoo. Those 2 blockers cannot hold back Alley Kate Contusions. She is your lead jammer in this jam. Also out of the pack is Pow Pow Panther. Again, only 2 blockers out there. Nice little move from the outside in, deking her way through that wall. She picks up all 4 points. 99 for Kalamazoo.
58 for Gold Coast, 40 seconds left. We will have another jam in this first half, but before we do that, I'd like to remind you to check out the WFTDA merchandise available at WFTDA.com/store. All the tournament merchandise here. There's the retro, the throwback sale, as it were. You can get previous tournament merchandise from previous years and even previous iterations of tournament structure that don't exist anymore. So check it out.
Bitchin' and Rollin' trying to get through, taking a uniform whip off of Souljourner. It's Jessie Girl in the pack still for Kalamazoo. That two wall at the front doing a nice job of holding up Jessie Girl and getting some reinforcements from the notorious R.E.D. penalty box. Now it is empty. 5-on-5 roller derby underway. And Lead Jammer going to Bitchin' and Rollin'. She's having a great game blocking. And now with an opportunity to pick points up for Gold Coast, a high block. It's going to send Bandita to the notorious R.E.D. penalty box. And still stuck in that pack is Jessie Girl. Now finding the inside line. She's going to escape. And she's being hunted down by Bitchin' and Rollin', who has 4 points. And you know she wants that last single, but she's not going to hustle. All the Kalamazoo points are at the back. Calls off the jam and picks up 2 more.
That the wall was staggered in there, and all she had to do was follow the curve of it to the outside, past those hips, calls it off. Captain Lou, that's 30 minutes of roller derby here between Kalamazoo Derby Darlings, Gold Coast Derby Girls All-Stars for the bronze. Good first half, strong from Kalamazoo. I would say they came out early, played clean, got Gold Coast into some penalty trouble. It flexed back the other way, but they've done a good job responding, and I think Gold Coast is showing that they're not giving anything up. No. We're going to see a strong early second half, I would predict, from Gold Coast.
Yeah, and I think that's exactly what's going to happen. They'll go back to the dressing room. They've got some tricks in their bag they can pull out against Kalamazoo in the second half. That lead is not safe at 99-64. Captain Lou Obamo.
AK 40 ounce.
Going into halftime, make sure you come back for the 3-4 game.
My name is Brenda Gold, and I've been at Riddell for 36 years almost. Everything is done by hand, basically. Just a one pair actually going through at a time then. And some of them are multiple colors where it'll have 5-6 colors, metallics, the different colored full grains, you name it. Some of them are pretty wild. To me, the skaters are really important because that's what keeps us going here. It's the consumer or the skater that decides, okay, is it good enough for me or not? We want them to be happy, that's for sure.
They told us to just sell skates online. You won't have any overhead. Put some skulls in your advertising, you'll make a mint. That was never our plan. Our plan was to make a store where all day we are fitting skaters, fixing skates, teaching customers, and putting the best gear on their bodies. Before we put 3 W's in front of our name, we made sure we had hundreds of happy customers come through our doors. We're not just Derby owned, we're Derby dedicated. Fast Girl Skates.
Gatekeepers.
Bell Star, Rose City Rollers,
Erkin Martin, Denver Roller Dolls,
Jimmy Mission, Atlanta Roller Girls,
Meow Mix, Jacksonville Roller Girls,
Kiki Your Ass from Pikes Peak Derby Dames,
Shane Bauer, St. Louis Gatekeepers.
I trust.
I skate.
I am.
I am Noah Derby.
Are you the jammer assist?
Why do you ask?
You sure smell offensive!
Notorious sports gear deodorant, because Fredo's is not a cologne.
Now I know why it's called a penalty box.
Hi!
Notorious sports gear deodorant.
Take the hint.
We're back, AK.
That we are, Captain Lou Albamo on WFTDA.tv, bringing you the second half of the Gold Coast Derby Girls All-Stars against the Kalamazoo Derby Darlings. Great first half, Captain Lou.
It has been a great first half. Again, this is the bronze medal matchup. Kalamazoo with 99 points, Gold Coast with 64 points, a back-and-forth affair. Kalamazoo, though, playing a very clean game. AK, you've got some stats for us?
I do indeed have stats. Looking at the two teams, 13 minutes in the box for Kalamazoo, 23 minutes for Gold Coast.
Right.
The strange thing within those numbers, though, is 5 trips to the box for the Jammers of Kalamazoo and only 3 for Gold Coast. So Kalamazoo keeping it cleaner in the pack, but more jammer penalty troubles.
Right, and yet still able to keep the lead in this game, and they're up by 35 points, even though they've given up 2 extra power jams.
Yeah, and let's take a look at the scorers right now. Lucy Lunatic doing a really good job. The physical jamming approach coming in with 23 points, 20 points for Kitten Out Submitting, and 21 points for Bitchin' and Rollin'. Their other jammers have not been able to put up any points. Pow Pow Panther, Suki Skankhouse, and Souljourner in their seven collective jams have scored none. Right. On the other side of things, Alley Cake Contusions out there, along with Dubois, both picking up 18 points, 30 points for Heckler, and 33 points, the leading scorer, Jesse Girl.
So points spread out very nicely on the Kalamazoo side. You have to wonder if we're going to see Baller Shot Collar with the star on her head in the second half for Gold Coast.
Yeah, I would not be surprised. They tend to save her. She's been doing a lot of work in the pack, though. She has been one of their most effective blockers in the pack. Luckily, she's only got two penalties in the first half. You have to watch it out for Lucy Lunatic. She is the leading scorer. She has four trips to Notorious RED penalty box, four trips for Bandita as well on the side of Gold Coast things, and leading penalty obtainer Heartless Hottie, three trips to the Notorious RED penalty box for Kalamazoo.
Now, we did not get to the officials for this game at the beginning. We were cut a little bit short. We'll do it right now. The head referee is Code Adam. The inside pack ref is Laddie. Jam refs are Deuce Willis and Zed Dork. And the OPRs are David Feckham, Rollbar, and Tall Glass of Water. And the gentleman who's assisting your announcers in crime, AK and myself, is Cool Hand Luke, who's been doing a great job all weekend. We do love our announcer refs.
For sure we do. They bring us all the official review information, and so we can bring it to you. And at the end of the first half, we saw some love between Dubois and Baller Shot Caller after a great hit by Baller taking down Doobie. And now we're seeing them on the jammer line chatting it up, getting friendly. Two, again, fierce competitors, really good skaters. They're going to be jamming against each other, and they're just sharing some smiles and some war stories probably.
Savoring the last half of the 3-4 game, the last game for these teams at this Division II tournament from Kitchener-Waterloo, Ontario, Canada. And we are going to get action underway. Bitchin' and Rollin' to the outside and being held up by that Kalamazoo wall that performed so well in the first half. But a nice apex jump will get Bitchin' and Rollin' out of the pack. Really acrobatic work on the part of the jammer from Gold Coast.
Yeah, Doobie Trap there almost getting out clean, but got taken down hard by Baller Shot Caller. Sprung back up and finished her initial pass, but way before she could get back around. 4 points for Bitchin' and Rollin' and Gold Coast.
And it looks like they're going to go back with Lucy Lunatic.
Would not be surprised. That has been their most effective jammer. She was their most effective jammer. Bitchin' and Rollin' coming up with lead percentage, 67 lead for Bitchin' and Rollin'. Lucy Lunatic, 4 out of 8, not too bad, and was the leading scorer until that last jam.
And ducks around a hit from the outside and gets lead jammer for the second jam in a row for Gold Coast. Heckler held up at the back, and that's Baller Shot Caller, who pushes her out of bounds, forces her to reset. Heckler now with one to beat, and again, that one to beat is Baller Shot Caller, who gets a piece of her, and she's going to cycle back. Nice revenge hit on the part of number 365, Misbehaving. She'll go to the Notorious RED penalty box, and Heckler still stuck in that pack, and here comes 5 points for Lucy Lunatic, continuing to score, AK.
Oh, big hit right there. Roller Rammer going down hard. Slow to get up. Knocked her helmet around. Meanwhile, lots of bodies going down. And a track cut here on Heckler.
Uh-oh.
This game's getting a little crazy, Captain Lou.
Yeah, it's going into the cuckoo land, as we've seen all weekend long. From her bottom, calling off the jam, Lucy Lunatic, 4 points. She had some friendly fire incidents going on that last pass as well. She was knocked to the ground hard. Gonna be a power start though, okay?
Yes, it will, and it's gonna be brought to us in part by Radar Wheels. Radar Presto is a proud Pow Pow Panther? No. Proud partner of the WFTDA broadcast, radarwheels.com. Not necessarily endorsed by said skater.
A proud Pow Pow Panther will be standing in front of the Fast Girl Skate start line, but it is Bitchin' and Rollin' on this power start. Baller Shot Caller looked to perhaps provide some offense, but decided that she would come back play passive.
And you see out there, Javelin going for that last hit, way out of play. There, a big hit attempt from number 365. That is misbehaving, and it dislodged the jammer and helped her around on her five-point scoring pass, Lou.
Yeah, that 5 points brings the score to 99 to 87. Again, Gold Coast in the red, Kalamazoo in the black. Power jam is over. Never with a nice pop to the outside. That forces Pitchin to roll in the reset, but she resets very quickly and back through the pack, picks up another 5 points for Gold Coast. Now 99 to 92. Sojourner to the notorious RED penalty box. Hector trying to play a little defense as she is stuck at the back of the pack, having come out after that power jam completed. Pitching and rolling, done with this pass. No additional points. No, we're checking with Zed Dork, see what he's going to say.
And Captain Lou, what I'm going to say here is 28 to nothing. That make is the second half.
Three more points, AK. Yeah,
okay, make it 31 to nothing run here coming out of halftime. I don't know how I predicted that one. I had a feeling that they were going to come out strong, as you would expect from a team that's down. But they've done well in drawing penalties and putting up points.
It's like you've been watching the roller derby action all weekend long, AK.
Yeah, you'd think.
Allie Kate Contusions up against Lucy Lunatic. Lead jammer going to Allie Kate Contusions, but Lucy Lunatic out of the pack. And Allie Kate Contusions with a nice pop to the inside. That's going to force Lucy Lunatic back into the pack. Sort of a variation on the Eat the Baby. Not quite. It's more of a jammer knockout and then run and go as the pack reabsorbed her. Lucy Lunatic out of the pack again now. Allie Kate Contusion takes a big hit by Sookie Skankow. Only able to get a single, but that puts him at 100.
Yeah, great job right there by Allie Kate Contusions. I think instead of Eat the Baby, since there was a knockdown, it should be Baby Takeout.
I like that.
Yeah, there you go.
The Baby Takeout.
And you can take your baby out to do some open skating on your Rydell Skates. Rydell Skates, defining the concept of fit for over 65 years. That's RydellSkates.com.
On the fast girl skate, star line is once again Bitchin' and Rowan up against number 89 in black. That is Jessie Girl. The walls are not moving at all as the whistle is blown. The jam is underway. Jessie Girl resets and goes to the outside. Big hit by Neva on Bitchin' and Rowan. She gets lead jammer and then bodies falling over top of her. She gets up and keeps on going. She's got one to beat at the front of the pack. She's going to let her go. Lead jammer and off to the races is Bitchin' and Rowan, down by 5 points. Gold Coast. Jessie Girl desperately trying to get out of the pack. And now, does she escape? Yes. She is out. But 4 points by Bitchin' and Rowan will make it a one-point game. Does she want that single, or is she going to call it off? Not going to expend the energy. Nice move by Gold Coast early on in this game, AK.
Impressive run here in the second half. Captain Lou, only 1 point for Kalamazoo here after the halftime. Coming out, they've got to change something up. Now it might be an okay time to call a timeout if they can't do it on the fly, because they're looking at 27-31. A big run here. I'm not going to do math.
A big run for Gold Coast at the beginning of the second half.
Needless to say, they've closed it to within one.
Yeah. So any gap that was there is pretty much gone.
Yep.
Dubois facing off against number zero. That is Sookie Skankos. Sookie Skankos has not scored in this game yet. She is pushing up against the front wall of black skaters from Kalamazoo. She will get lead jammer. She will have an opportunity to add to her total, which is, well, currently zero, so it has to be better than after this jam. Dubois coming around and knocked to the outside. Sookie Skankos, hands are going to the hips. We're looking for the points. Zed Dork going to the outside, checking with tall glass of water. Four, and we have ourselves a lead change.
Wow, Captain Lou, incredible, huge second half opening here for the Gold Coast Derby Girls All-Stars. Heartless Hottie being sent to the box right at the end there. It's leading the penalty getters for Kalamazoo. Four for her Lucy Lunatic. And Bandita coming into the second half with four. We're six jams in, and they have not accrued anymore. Pretty clean here for Gold Coast.
3-on-2 pack advantage for Gold Coast. Heckler going up against Lucy Lunatic. Lucy Lunatic taking an inside line, running up against Javelin, having to reset, now looking for an outside line. Heckler also taking that line, and it's going to be Lucy Lunatic through for lead jammer. One to beat. That one is Bitchin' and Rowan. Nice move to the outside by Heckler. We'll get past her. She's off to the races and trying to chase down Lucy Lunatic. 2-on-2 pack. One will get you three. And a big hit by Javelin, but the call off. No points for Kalamazoo. 3 points, like I said, all those penalties.
Yep. But you know what? The big takedown did save them one extra point. So good job to Javi, I suppose. And a good job earlier. Baller Shot Caller was the one woman blocking show against Heckler at the beginning. She is the only one sitting in the penalty box for her extended effort that went beyond the bounds of the law, as they say.
On the Fast Girl Skates start line.
Easy for us to say.
Apparently. Number 9, Kitten Not Submitting in red and in black is 1148 Alley K Contusion. Alley K Contusion with a nice move. She's going to get lead jammer for Kalamazoo. Jesse Girl playing pivot and defense, keeping Kitten Not Submitting back in the pack. They cycled her back. That allowed Alley K Contusion to get all the way back through. She gets knocked down by Sojourner. And Alley K Contusion is off and through, and that's a 5-point grand slam. That's a natural because every skater was on the track. Not now, as number 422, that's Annihilating Annie going to Notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
Oh.
Still stuck in that pack. This Kit Not Submitting, and Alley K Contusion is going to get knocked out as well.
Yeah, the dude getting in on the physicality of this game has got ran into by Annihilating Annie on her way to the penalty box. But back on the floor, it's slowed up and just hitting, grinding out there, Captain Lou.
And Kitten Not Submitting still unable to get out of the pack, but Alley K Contusion has had enough, but she does get another 5-10 points for the clutch jammer from Kalamazoo.
Yeah. And you know what? I guess I didn't need the timeout. Good adjustment on the fly to start pulling ahead. It's still only a 4-point game, though, with 20:45 left in this 3-4 matchup. We are seeing the originally number 4 seed in Kalamazoo take on the originally number 7 seed in Gold Coast.
Jam about to get out of the way. The dude getting off the track at the last second, bitching and rolling, looking to get Gold Coast back in the lead. Dubois trying to preserve the lead for Kalamazoo. They just took it back in the last jam. Pack moving back and forth. It's going to be Dubois getting past the pivot for Gold Coast. That was Baller Shot Caller, who did a backward somersault after that hit, got back up on her skates. And lead jammer to Kalamazoo, but she wasn't the foremost jammer, had to call it off, double goose egg.
Yeah, good pressure there by Dubois, keeping the heat on, bitching and rolling. See the red skaters in the back, thus the call off. Quick look at points so far in this game. Bitchin' and Rollin' leading with 42 points. Right behind her, Jessie Girl, 33 for Kalamazoo. Heckler with 30. So no points from Heckler here in the second half. Nothing from Jessie Girl. Alley K Contusions, though, has put up the 11 points that have kept KDD in the lead.
5-on-5 roller derby action from the Fast Girl Skate start line. Lucy Lunatic up against Heckler. Heckler stymied at the back. Lucy Lunatic through for lead jammer. Heckler trying to take an outside line. Comes up against her own blocker, Merica. Gets a uniform whip off her, nice little hip whip, gets going. She's going to get out, but here comes Lucy Lunatic, runs into Heartless Hottie. And she's the last line, though, coming in for some hits.
Oh.
Calls off the jam, 3-4 points, and almost Heckler picking up points.
Yeah, a great job by Emma Pistol coming up recycling. Heartless Hottie just left a tiny bit of space there for her to get through, and Emma Pistol came up. Hit her, stopped her from completing that pass, but it was enough to tie the game, Lou. 110, 18:41 left. We've played, 51 minutes, and it's like it never happened. It's basically 0-0.
Yeah, 41 minutes if you want to.
Yeah, something.
Yeah, you know. That's all right. That's all right.
Math.
We'll see in 10 minutes if it's still a tie. Jam on the way, Alley K Contusion picking up a forearm penalty. She'll go to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box. It is now a power jam, and they have Bitchin' and Rollin' out on the track for Gold Coast. I suspect they are happy to see her out there because she's been able to put up big points. Coming in hard, knocking Neva to the ground. Not an easy task under any situation. 5 points for Bitchin' and Rollin'. And that pair of Neva and Javelin are waiting for her to come around again.
Yeah, jailbreak in the back. KDD getting all their blockers back. And they're able to bridge it out, but it's too late. 4 points right there for Bitchin' and Rollin' as she pushed past Neva and Javi.
Bitchin' and Rollin' is so good at just skirting that line on the inside or outside, staying in bounds. Now back in, all the reinforcements are out there for Kalamazoo. It's a wall of four at the front. The power jam is over. Allie K. Contusions back on the track, but she is on her initial pass. Pitching and rolling. Again, getting knocked around by Heartless Hottie and Javelin. There goes Allie K. Contusion out of the pack. Big hit by Heartless.
Oh, big hit right there on the other side of things coming from Rageaholic Rex.
Javelin still playing it relatively safe in this game. 5 points for Bitchin and 2 points for Kalamazoo, scoring now 124-112 for Gold Coast.
Gold Coast points, Bitchin and Roland 56, 44 for Lucy Lunatic and 20 for Kitten Not Submitting. Yeah, Lucy Lunatic, as we mentioned, it's been an interesting story to watch the flow of jammers through Gold Coast. Bitchin and Roland has been consistent. Lucy Lunatic, this is only her second game jamming out of the four this weekend. Sojourner, mixed success. Pow Pow Panther was one of the names in the first game, but she's basically just done blocking. And we haven't even seen Baller out jamming in this game for Gold Coast, Captain Lou.
It is a timeout for Kalamazoo. A single left for them. They still have their official review in the half.
Yeah. But 16:45 remaining, that's a lot of time. And you got to be careful with that time management. Again, with 16:45 left, it's 124 Gold Coast, 112 for Kalamazoo. Gold Coast has pushed back. And you are joining us here live from Kitchener, Waterloo, Ontario on WFTDA.TV. That is some speculation from our producer. Perhaps Baller not jamming because of her finger injury sustained earlier this weekend. It's a possibility. Then again, right now, we're seeing, just mentioned her, Pow Pow Panther, back out there jamming. Gold Coast keeping them on their heels, throwing different things at them, and seeing what sticks, Captain Lou.
Also on the Fast Girl Skate start line is Jessie Girl. It is going to be 5-on-5 roller derby action. A 12-point lead for Gold Coast in the red, Kalamazoo in the black. And we get the jam underway. Pow Pow Panther trying to take an outside line. She's got roller rammer holding her on that outside line, not giving an inch, trying to keep her back. At the front of the pack is Jessica with a nice little skip and lead jammer.
Amazing effort leading up to said skip. She just squeezed through, rolled around, Baller shot collar, got up between that two wall, pushed her way through right there on one skate, goes backwards, up out of bounds, and calls it up. 4 points, got them all, did Jessie Girl. And none points for Pow Pow Panther. Our score, 8 points right now. Gold Coast still in the lead after retaking it here in the first half of the second half.
Now, I've been saying Heartless Hottie's name a lot in this game, AK, but she's in some penalty trouble.
Yeah, she just came up in this past year from their B team. She's been a big part of their defense here this weekend and has had some penalty trouble. She got 6 against the outfit, another physical game, and right now knocking on heaven's door.
Dubois jamming against Lucy Lunatic. Lucy Lunatic winning the battle once again, getting lead jammer. Dubois is hot on her tail, 30 feet back. Pack setting up for the approach of the jammers. Lucy Lunatic looking to score. Hands go to the hips. I think 4 points were just stolen by Kalamazoo, though.
Neva, smile on her face, bossed up on that one. Locked up on Lucy Lunatic. And right before that, it was the fall of Sojourner. Fell into the Neva's legs, knocked her down. 2 skaters to the box for Gold Coast. So it's going to be a 3-2 pack advantage here for Kalamazoo. Captain Blue, who is back on the Fast Girl Skate start line.
Allie K. Contusions and 000. That's Bitchin' and Rolling for Gold Coast. 3-on-2 pack advantage for Kalamazoo. The pivot line in use once again. Bitchin' and Rolling using that agility. Oh, a big hit by Bitchin' and Rolling. But in the process of throwing that big hit, she allowed Allie K. Confusion to get lead jammer. And now the Kalamazoo blockers have recycled and have her back in the pack. She's finally going to get out, but Allie K. Contusion is through. And that's 7.
That's it for Heartless Hottie. Number 77 picks up her 7th. There we go. Jammers approaching. Bitchin' and Rolling taking a hit from Allie K. And a call off, so no points on that one. Tie game again. F. Lou El Bamo. I'm so excited. 14-12.
Why would you be?
I have no idea. Because we've had fantastic derby all weekend. So many close games. About 80%, I would say.
It's right up there, yeah.
Yeah, within the WFTDA record single jam points. And we're looking at another one as we are looking at Heartless Hottie being escorted to the locker room as she has fouled out of this game. Kalamazoo will have to field a substitute into the penalty box, and they will look to Miss B. Haven to take a seat along with the other penalized player, Crash of Aggressive.
So it will be a 4-on-2 pack advantage for Gold Coast. Again, the score is deadlocked. It is tied 124-124, 13 minutes, 55 seconds remaining in this bronze medal matchup. My word.
Indeed. And my word is Fast Girl Skates. Get your league sponsored for discount products. Email sponsorship at fastgirlskates.com.
It's Lucy Lunatic going up against Heckler again. Gold Coast in red, Kalamazoo in black. This is a 4-on-2 pack advantage, but Lucy Lunatic cannot take advantage of it as Neva and Javelin have held her and cycled her back. And lead jammer going to Heckler. We saw that in the first half. The Gold Coast managed to get a lead jammer with two blockers in the box. Now Kalamazoo coming through clutch with Heckler.
Yeah, huge right here. We saw a lot of Heckler early in the first half. Right there, finishing a four-pointer. Nice and easy with some help from her friends. And saw a lot of Heckler in the first half. Haven't seen her for a stretch. She got shut down on a couple quick jams. But maybe speculating again, but what do we know? Maybe saving her for the home stretch as they've got that four-jammer rotation, keeping it pretty tight. And it has been a six-jammer rotation with Heavy Bitchin' and Rollin' and Lucy Lunatic from Gold Coast.
Well, that home stretch is exactly where we are right now. Kalamazoo in the lead by 4 points. Bitchin' and Rollin' looking for an outside line. Jessie Girl waiting to make sure that her wall is solid before she makes a move. Now takes an outside line. Swing and a miss by Baller Shot Caller. Gets lead jammer in a hurry.
Oh, my goodness. Sweet baby Jesus. That was a big hit right there. Offensive knockdown. Wow.
Jessica was going to get the hands on the hip. She's going to get them in time. One single point, though, for Bitchin' and Rollin' laughs as she doesn't really land the apex jump, but picked up that point before she hit. 3 points for Kalamazoo. 6-point lead for the Michiganders.
Ooh, 131-125. 12:14 left in this game, Captain Lou. just going to let the action speak for itself. And thanks to Adam Wheels for letting that happen. Want a game-changing experience? Check out Pilot Plates and Vertigo Boots. And you know Gold Coast would love a game-changing experience right now, down by six.
Down by six. Sojourner on the line with a star in her head. She's going to take that outside line. She's got to lead jammer. Javelin trying to get one last hit. Another last-ditch effort by Lily St. Smear, but she is off to the races. But they held her up just long enough for Dubois to get out. It's going to get hands in the hips. No points. Double fists.
Yeah,
6-point lead remains.
And we're getting into that territory, Captain Lou, with under 12 minutes left to play. Time is of the essence.
Yes, it is. And you got to wonder if maybe that early timeout by Kalamazoo, I mean, they came back nicely as a result, but they only have one timeout left plus that OR. That gets you in the danger zone for time management.
Yeah, meanwhile, Gold Coast, two timeouts and their official review remaining. Right back into the action. We've got Bitchin' and Rollin' up against Alley Kit Contusions. No room on the outside for either jammer, and they're just going to have to push against those respective walls.
Up at the front, Bitchin' and Rollin' has won the beat, gets past her, and now is lead jammer. Now Alley Kit Contusions also getting out of the pack. Now the pack needs to settle itself out. The jammer race is on. Bitchin' and Rollin' coming off of the back-to-back. Coming in hot, takes the outside line. She is going to pick up all 4 points. It is now a 2-point game, AK.
Absolutely incredible. Great job by Baller Shot Caller to set that offensive pick out there. And Captain Lou, penalties picked up there at the end of that jam. Lily St. Smear got hers in the beginning for that out of play. And meanwhile, Emma Pistol holstered as well in the notorious RED penalty box.
Nice. I like that. That
thanks.
2-point game, 131 KDD, 129 for Gold Coast. 10 minutes remaining in this game. Another jam underway. 4-on-2 pack advantage. Here comes Lily St. Smear. That'll make it a 4-on-3 pack advantage for Gold Coast. Sojourner cannot find a gap. Big hit by Javelin. Pushes her to the inside. She's going to be able to recycle her back. Nice revenge hit by Annihilating Annie. But Soljourner cycling back. Soljourner with a nice hop. She is going to get lead jammer. Heckler has not been able to get on the pack yet for Kalamazoo. She's getting cycled back by Baller Sharp Collar. Here comes Soljourner, looking for an opportunity to regain the lead for Gold Coast. Takes the outside line. Finds her friend Javelin one more time. And at the front, Lily St. Smear can't contain her 5-point lead change.
And we're going to have a star pass here. Neva taking the star from Heckler. We have a new jammer, and that was a good job right there. Heads up play to get that jammer out and at least put some pressure on.
Soljourner with the hands and hips. Two more points. Gold Coast 136-131. 5-point lead for the ladies from Florida.
Yeah, they're trading paint and they're trading leads here as we are under 10 minutes left to play. 9-10 left in this game. 136-135 in favor of Gold Coast. They both want that shiny bronze, gold enough looking medal. They'll know in their hearts, though, what the situation is.
I'm more than happy to take a bronze medal if the other option is fourth place and nothing. Bitchin' and Rollin' Jessie Girl are on the Fast Girl Skate start line. Again, a slow, grinding start.
And as they are pushing here, we're going to take a second to check Twitter. Ariane Levert says, you need a mouth guard just to watch the hits by these KDD blockers on hashtag talk to WFTDA.
Your announcer friends are getting whiplash as we're watching this ourselves. Lead jammer going to Bitchin' and Rollin'. Jessie Girl getting on the pack as well. So again, the pack sets up. Bitchin' and Rollin' coming around at the back. The blockers in black can't get a piece of Bitchin' and Rollin'. She goes off on one foot and finally gets the hands to the hips. 4 points for Bitchin' and Rollin'. She's not happy with Zeddork at all.
Yeah, was not contacting out there. You see the dude talking to Code Adam about not touching right there. The dude, background in refereeing before he went over into the bench for KDD. So a lot of times you'll see him out there talking with people he has worked with in the past.
Yeah, you can't make phantom taps to the hips. You got to get those hands right on those babies.
Yep. You got to make contact. We've seen a lot of contact made here. 140, 131, and a penalty right off the start. It is going to be Lucy Lunatic headed to the Notorious RED penalty box. There'll be her fifth trip. Only two of those as a jammer, and it's a power jam now for KDD. But the Gold Coast defense looking solid here, Lou.
And they've got Dubois, who really wants this for Kalamazoo. Oh. Wow, Neva
Soba just... Wow, double hit right there, taking out both defenders out front. Good mercy, here they come again. Oh, and Doobie getting tripped up right there as the offense sprung into action.
She's getting a little bit of friendly fire as the Kalamazoo offensive blockers got a little worked up. She's going to call it off. They're going to freeze Bitchin' and Rollin'. Lucy Lunatic in the Notorious RED penalty box picks up 4 points, now down by five, 140-135, 6 minutes and 50 seconds remaining in the game.
You can watch this on the archive at WFTDA.tv soon. I would recommend it because there's been so much action, so many hits, that even if you didn't blink, you probably missed some of it. And, you know, Captain Lou, this is the end of D2, nearly. There is one more game after this.
One more game, Reno Valley, Bear City, the international matchup. This game is not done. 6.5 minutes remaining. 5 points separate these teams. Gold Coast still in lead. This is a power start. Heckler to getting lead jammer. Soljourner with the last ditch ever. Oh, and a dive by Gold Coast. Bitchin' and Rollin'. She did not get a piece of her. I think there won't be any result from that. Out of the penalty box with Lucy Lunatic. Threw on her initial pass. Heckler on the outside, chased by Baller Shot Collar. Baller will not get a piece of her. 4 points for Kalamazoo. 139-140. A single point separates these teams.
Can you hear that, folks? That is the sound of the action here from Kitchener, Waterloo, Ontario International D2 Playoffs of the WFTDA, brought to you by the Tri-City Roller Derby and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association, as well as Captain Lou and myself as we try to maintain our cool in this incredible 3-4 game. All right, Suki Skankhouse wearing the star up against Jessie Girl. Two smaller, quick jammers. Captain Lou, we got 5-on-5.
Suki Skankhouse trying to make her way through the front of that black blocking wall from Kalamazoo. Looks like she's going to get out lead jammer. Gold Coast with a single point. Will she play jammer defense? No, she's going to get the hands and the hips. She's going to take the time off the clock. 5 minutes remaining in this game. Still a single point lead for Gold Coast.
The Blue Streak by Rydell. Raw power, just add skater. Rydell skates. Facebook.com.
That was very calm.
Thank you.
That was very calm because I could not say it that calmly right now.
It's because my heart has already exploded and my brain is slowly dying because this game is friggin' awesome. 140, 139, 445 nearly right now left on the clock. Captain Lou, Gold Coast KZU.
Here we go. 5-on-5 roller derby action. Dubois bitching and rolling. Dubois looks for an outside line. Comes up against Baller Shot Collar. He seems to be out there for every jam now. Dubois trying to wedge her way through that wall of black at the back. Baller Shot Collar gets her out of bounds. Forces a track cut on Dubois. Came in. Baller had not gone out. This is a power jam for bitching and rolling. Dubois has not hit the notorious RD penalty box. Now she has 30 seconds. 30 seconds for Bitchin' and Rollin' and Gold Coast to put points on the board with 4 minutes remaining in this game, AK.
Yep, coming up on 4 minutes and coming up on the four wall is Bitchin' and Rollin', taken down to the inside right there by Allie Kate Contusions. She's going to spring back up as Allie Kate is headed to Notorious RD penalty box. That's 5 points, a little bit of a buffer right now, 6 point lead for Gold Coast.
Standing in the Notorious RD penalty box is Dubois. Here comes Bitchin' and Rollin' looking for another scoring pass. Nice move by Baller Shot Collar to open up that line for Bitchin' and Rollin'. She's got 10 now. Power jam is over. Bitchin' and Rollin' again with those phantom hip taps. Takes a little while for the actual hits to happen. But Gold Coast now with an 11-point lead, AK.
Yeah, it was an 8-0 run in 3 jams for Kalamazoo. Gold Coast striking back 10-0, taking advantage of the power jam and doing so very well. They executed perfectly. Kalamazoo's walls were just, with only 3 blockers out there, they weren't compact enough, and they didn't have the lateral range to get that jammer held up, and 11 points is now our difference with 3:35 left in this game. Captain Lou,
yeah.
Say something.
Well, you know, the dude took a timeout.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And you know what that means? There are no more timeouts left on Kalamazoo's board. They do have their official review remaining, but with 3:35 left.
Well, man, that is walking.
People could critique that if they were so inclined.
That is a time management nightmare to have as a coach when you're down by 11 points, 3 minutes and 35 seconds. The question is, can you get lead jammer? Can you run these jams? If you're Gold Coast, kill the clock. Kalamazoo claw back in. 11 points are separating Kalamazoo and Gold Coast. Gold Coast currently has the lead for this bronze medal matchup.
Okay, quick look at penalties. Suki Skankhouse, Baller Shot Collar, and Lucy Lunatic all with 5. That could come into play. We've already lost Heartless Hottie on a foul out. Big takedown right there. Javelin.
Oh, and a forearm penalty. A forearm penalty to Heckler. She's going back to the Taurus RD penalty box. We also have a track cut. A track cut to Lucy Lunatic. This is going to turn into a 2-minute jam with only 3 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in this game. Little bit of a blowout coming into the Taurus RD penalty box. Lucy Lunatic. This will give Heckler a little more opportunity to try to complete this initial pass. Neither of these jammers have made it through the pack yet.
Yeah, about a 5-step jump there for Heckler. She takes advantage of it and draws a multiplayer block. So it'll be a 4-3 pack advantage for Kalamazoo right here.
Now the Kalamazoo defense trying to lock down on Lucy Lunatic. Huge hit once again by the blockers in black. And they are keeping Lucy Lunatic in this pack. Heckler coming around on a scoring pass. That is 5 points. It is now a 6-point game with 2 minutes and 35 seconds remaining in this game. Looking for a star pass. Going to Baller Shot Collar. It's Team USA. And here comes Heckler through another 5. We are down to a single point. Gold Coast in the lead by 1 single point. A nice hit to the outside by Allie Kate Contusion.
And Javelin right there sending Baller down. Baller almost cut the track. Here again getting forced out by Dubois. An illegal procedure penalty being assessed right there to Cleopatra Heartbreaker. So out of the pack now is Baller Shot Collar, but she's losing a blocker. And the points are going up right now for KDD.
Here comes Heckler. She's got 19 points on this jam so far. They were down by 11. They're up by 8. Baller threw on a scoring pass, though. She's going to get 4 points. This jam is continuing again. line. There is still 14 seconds left. A nice whip will get Heckler through another 4 points for Kalamazoo. Baller shot caller trying to get the points as time is running out on his clock. Heckler will probably not get back in time to score anything. Big hit to the outside by Dubois.
Wow! 4 points, baller shot caller. One more point scored right at the end by Heckler. What a huge run right there. Heckler was big at the beginning. She was shut down for a while. They moved her over for a little while and comes up huge with a 24-8 jam for Kalamazoo. I didn't even look at the score. They retook the lead, 163-158, 5-point game. This time in favor of KDD, and we got a minute and a half left, as well as a timeout for Gold Coast, Captain Lou.
If I ever have trouble with my manual transmission car, I'm calling her because she is clutch. 5-point game. Kalamazoo with a huge effort. 90
massive,
seconds.
Massive effort right there. Heckler adding to her stat total. Leading scorer for KDD. 62 points for her after that big one right there. 26 points for Doobie, 40 for Jesse Girl, and 35 for Allie Kate. Meanwhile, a 75 for Bitchin' and Rowan, 20 for Kitten Matsumin, and 52 for Lucy Lunatic.
A little bit of a scoring adjustment makes it a 164-158 point game. That is a 6-point game. That is important.
Yes, it is.
That is more than one pass unless you can somehow get the double jammer point. 90 seconds, Gold Coast with this timeout, resetting, 6-point game, 90 seconds to go.
Captain Lou, Lucy Lunatic, 6 trips to Notorious RD penalty box.
She's putting her out there.
She has been so important to this jammer rotation. It'll be interesting, but they do have a deep jammer bench. So who are the jammers?
5-on-5 roller derby. We'll see Bitchin' and Rollin', Jesse Girl facing off. Jesse Girl to the inside. Baller shot caller with a high block. Now it's going to be a 4-on-3 pack advantage. And cycling all the way back. Dubois dancing her way back, bringing Bitchin' and Rollin'. Lead jammer to Jesse Girl. Kalamazoo has the opportunity to kill the clock if they wish. Bitchin' and Rollin' cannot get out of the pack yet, AK.
No, she cannot, and you know what? All they have to do is stay out of the penalty box. Play it smart right here. Great movement in the pack through Jessie Girl. 5 points, and I bet you Gold Coast wishes they had Jessie Girl right now because she is putting up numbers continuing at the end of this game. Stays in on 1 foot. Stays in. Amazing movement along the pack right there. Athleticism at its finest. Real strong athletic revolutionary, and 5 points goes up right there for KDD.
WFDDA action at its finest. Is Bitchin' and Rollin' coming back into the back. Here comes Jesse Girl. Jesse Girl with an opportunity to run this clock as she's been able to put multiple scoring passes up on the scoreboard. Soldier doing a good job of pinning her in there, but to the outside, a nice little bump. Bitchin' and Rollin' unable to get past her.
And Jesse Girl right there forced to the outside, saw the jammer coming up, forced her out, spun around, and she is just going to open skate this one to its conclusion. 4 more points are added to KDD's total. Score right now, 178-162 as 4 points are added for Bitchin' and Rollin'. Period time has run out. We are on jam time, and they're going to call it up from the outfield. And back-to-back years. Back-to-back years. Kalamazoo will go home with bronze. What an incredible game, Captain Lou.
Wow. Gold Coast with a fantastic second-half comeback. Took control of the game. Really had it going their way. Kalamazoo had to find another gear, had to dig deep into their bag of tricks because Gold Coast had come out gangbusters in this second half. Now this is, of course, that's not an unofficial final. I'm seeing final put up on the board. 180 for Kalamazoo, 160 for Gold Coast. That is your final. We're gonna get the skate arounds. AK, as you said, repeat bronze medalist, Kalamazoo Derby Darlings. Gold Coast gave them a good run for their money, but Kalamazoo in the last 3 minutes and 30 seconds pulled it off.
Absolutely incredible. And you know what? Although Kalamazoo will not be going to the WFTDA Championship weekend, they will close their season out against Detroit in Kalamazoo. The second weekend in October. We'll be looking forward to that one. They'll get a shot at their cross-state rivals. They have not played in 2 years. And Detroit's got something to watch out for, because if Kalamazoo plays like that, then it's going to be a really interesting game. Quick look at the penalties as we close this one out. Only 32 minutes. 16 minutes, 32 trips to the penalty box for Kalamazoo. On the other side of things, penalties did play a factor. Lucy Lunatic with 6, Baller Shot Caller ended with 6, and Suki Skankhouse with 6 as well.
But I tell you, Kalamazoo playing a very disciplined game, scoring KK.
Yeah, but again, as we said at halftime, and then looking at it now, 9 trips to the box for the Kalamazoo Jammers, 5 for Gold Coast.
Wow. So super defense on the part of Kalamazoo. Clutch work on the part of the Jammers from Kalamazoo to pull that back in. I think you really got to call the MVP of this game is the defense of Kalamazoo, though. That Javelin Neva pairing, fantastic in this game, both fouling out. Neva with 1 trip. 1 trip. Javelin with 2.
Yeah, they both fouled out the game before. You know, when they played the outfit, they stayed in and they were really effective. When they stay out on the floor, they make a huge difference. We're going to wrap this one up. We do have one more coming up, Captain Lou. But before we talk about that, let's just recap. Grand Raggedy takes 10th, beat by Boulder County. Demolition City 8th, Chicago Outfit 7th. Queen City beats DC for 5th place. And Kalamazoo will take home the bronze. And that's 2 medals to Michigan, my friends. And I'm happy to hear that. Because,
I'm sure you are.
You know.
I am happy for the fantastic Roly Derby game.
Yeah, it doesn't
matter.
You just
got to watch.
That was incredible. Gold Coast, you can't take anything away from him,
no.
Except for the medal. But right. All Dress Chips is a consolation prize, and they will get to watch this next incredible game.
Yeah.
You want to tease it?
What, Rideau Valley versus Bear City?
Yeah.
Germany versus Canada. Capital City teams from both countries, a Capital City matchup. First time 2 teams from outside of the U.S. of A. will face off for a championship in a Division II in any playoff.
And not only that, right here from Kitchener-Waterloo, Ontario, first WFTDA playoff tournament on Canadian soil.
I'm Captain Lou.
I'm AK-40 Ounce, and I think we both need to go have heart attacks. Thank
Seriously.
You for joining us. Our final score again, 181-62. Kalamazoo defeats Gold Coast for 3rd place. We'll be back in a little bit with the final on WFTDA.tv.
See you soon.
Love this guy.
Bacon and Trish the Dish here to tell you about Sin City Skates. Sin City Skates began in our living room in 2005 and has since grown into this 2,000 square foot warehouse and showroom where we stock everything for derby. If it's derby related, we probably have it. Need help? With a combined on-track derby experience of over 24 years and still playing, we test everything we sell and we know the difference between facts and our opinions. We're always happy to share both with you to help you make the right decisions. So call us, SinCitySkates.com.
This was definitely a proud moment for me, wearing the black, white, and red. It's such a bold uniform, first of all. It's just Texas right across. That's a team you skate out onto that track, and there's just no guessing who you are. You just feel the team. It feels very much like the kind of thing you want to wear out into battle, and it's really great. I like it. I'm Fifi Nominon with the Texas Roller Girls Texecutioners, and S1 is part of my uniform.
Watching WFTDA.tv.